Hi guys, welcome to Dr. Says. In this diabetes series, I'm going to talk to you about the common complications of diabetes. If you missed part 1 where I talk about how do doctors diagnose diabetes and pre-diabetes, you can click on the link above. Now, let's get on to it. Diabetes is what we call a systemic disease. It basically means it could affect every system in your body. A common way we screen for complications in our patients is to divide the complications into macrovascular and microvascular complications. Macro being big vessels and micro being small vessels. When you have high sugar in your blood, that is hyperglycemia, it promotes atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis basically means the thickening of your blood vessels. I will not bore you down by going into the details of how diabetes causes atherosclerosis, but you get it, thickening of your blood vessels. What this in turn does is causing a lack of blood supply to our organs due to narrowing of vessels, as there is a lack of oxygen. And as you know, blood carries oxygen. It is the lack of oxygen and nutrients in your organs that causes the majority of the complications. Examples of big vessels: vessels to heart, brain, and limbs. When there is a lack of oxygen to the heart, patients often develop chest pain or angina. When you develop chest pain on physical exertion, that is known as stable angina. If chest pain develops suddenly at rest, it is known as unstable angina. Eventually, if the block is severe enough to cause a total blockage of oxygen to your heart muscles dies, and this is what we call a myocardial infarction, aka heart attack. Similarly, if blood vessels to the brain are affected, it causes stroke. A milder form of stroke is known as transient ischemic attack, where patients suffer from a sudden loss of power in their limbs, temporarily and subsequently regain function. If blood vessels to limbs are affected, it will cause peripheral vascular disease. A common symptom patients often experience is claudication, i.e. pain in the legs and arms that comes with walking or using the arms. This is due to narrowing of blood vessels to the limbs and extremities. In severe cases, it will lead to gangrene, ulcers, and infections, ultimately needing amputations. Moving on to microvascular complications. Examples of small vessels are eye vessels, kidney vessels, and nerve vessels. Damage to eye vessels is known as diabetic retinopathy. Common symptoms include blurring of vision, transient loss of vision, or eye pain. It often takes years and years to develop. So, by the time you suffered from blurring of vision, it's too late. Besides the vessels, diabetes can also affect the lens, causing cataracts and glaucoma. If diabetes affects vessels to your nerve supplying your hands or feet, one may suffer from diabetic neuropathy, or what doctors call glove and stocking type of neuropathy. Signs and symptoms of peripheral neuropathy are often worse at night, and may include numbness or reduced ability to feel pain or temperature changes, tingling or burning sensation, sharp pains or cramps, serious foot problems such as ulcers, infections, bone and joint pain. This is why it is super important for diabetics to examine their hands and foot regularly for sores and infections, as they might not even feel it. When diabetes affects your kidney, it is known as diabetic nephropathy. There are 5 stages to it. In the early stages, a person may not even notice any symptoms, apart from frothy urine occasionally due to loss of protein in the urine. At later stages, they may feel unwell and experience the following symptoms: swollen ankles, feet, lower legs or hands due to water retention, darker urine due to blood in the urine, shortness of breath due to accumulation of fluids in the lung, fatigue due to lack of oxygen in the blood, nausea, vomiting, or itching of the skin due to building up of toxins known as urea in your blood. If one progresses to stage 5, it is known as end-stage renal failure, And sadly, dialysis is the only option to prolong your life. So, there you have it. These are the most common complications of uncontrolled diabetes we look for in our patients. Early detection of diabetes and proper control of blood sugar is essential to prevent most of these complications. Hope you guys learned something today. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.